U.S. President Joe Biden commended Colombian President Gustavo Petro's human rights track record in their first meeting at the White House on Thursday. The leaders, in statements before journalists at the start of the Oval Office meeting, struggled to retain the emphasis on parts of contract, comprising of consolidating their egalitarianisms and constructing economies less reliant on fossil fuels. We are going down the same river, a river that leads us to ever greater democracy and ever greater freedom, Petro said. We have a common agenda and a lot of work to do. Biden said the countries shared a goal to build a united, equal, democratic and economically prosperous Western Hemisphere, adding that Colombia is the key to the hemisphere. From fossil fuels to a green economy. In his comments, Petro highlighted the necessity for an in-depth shift from fossil fuels to a green economy, something Biden has spotlighted during his tenure in office, with a historic funding bill to inspire climate-friendly know-how and technology. We have the greatest potential for democracy and freedom in the Americas, as well as the greatest potential for green energies, Petro said. Petro was voted in June in part of an upsurge of left-leaning trailblazers to victory in Latin America. Joe Biden emphasized Colombia's welcome of huge records of immigrants from next-door Venezuela, whose far-left administration has masterminded years of economic breakdown and violent political uprising. Petro, his country's first left-wing commander-in-chief, made no remarks in the public sector of his statements on the predicament in Venezuela, where the United States has tried unproductively to overthrow the far-left leader Nicolas Maduro. Under Petro administration, Colombia's strategy toward Venezuela's totalitarian government has altered. Colombia no longer backs U.S.-led tactics to recluse Maduro and push him to step down or call for new elections. In its place, Petro's government has involved the Maduro, organized joint meetings and restarted ambassadorial associations, preventing drug smuggling. Biden said more regulations and bilateral policies to strengthen U.S. collaboration with Colombia to fight drug trafficking, another area where the countries take diverse methods. Previously, Petro snappishly condemned U.S.-led efforts to ban cocaine, saying at a speech at the United Nations last year that oil utilization endorsed by global powers is more toxic than cocaine and that the war on drugs has failed, said Petro. As cocaine production in Colombia surges in unreasonable quantities, Petro's administration has been unenthusiastic to destroy coca fields grown by small cultivators. The Colombian president said he is with the strong opinion to pursue money launderers and large-scale drug smugglers in place of depriving small farmers in remote areas of their livelihood.